Good evening, and welcome to our service of Compline on this Sunday, July 25th. I'm David Lehman, Bishop of Caledonia, and I'm joined this evening by the Dean.
Hello.
And we are on the traditional, ancestral, and unceded territory of the Tsimshian people, for which I am most grateful. I just got back 40 minutes ago, so I am happy to be back and be with you, and very thankful to the Dean for taking the service over the last 18 or so days while I was traveling and on vacation. Our worship this evening falls on the eve of the Feast of St. Anne, and it falls under one of those categories of it's complicated. Anne is the mother of Mary, and in the book of James, not the letter of James, the book of James, there is a story about how Mary was conceived, and because of her special conception, Jesus could be conceived. It gets complicated, and it's one of those things, it's kind of in the mythical realm, so we should leave it there. Same time, you know, she's the mother of Mary, so we will give her the courtesy she is due. But staying in that sort of field of mythical, I picked up a book I was very eager to read while I was on holidays, but I kept being interrupted by puppies and children, and there were belly rubs and stuff to be had. So I didn't get as far into the book as I'd like, but it's The Fall of Shannara, or Shannara, if you want to mispronounce it, as the guy who does the audiobook does. And it's the final book in a very long series by Terry Brooks about this mythical world of Shannara. And of course, you will know Terry Brooks as an incredible author of fantasy and science fiction. He brought us Star Wars Episode One, and we have forgiven him for that. But this is the final book in the Shannara series, and so yes, it's what I'm hoping to get through as I also read GAC reports. Our worship begins in the Book of Common Prayer, beginning on page 722. As we're in God's presence, let us pause, be still, and know that we're surrounded by God's grace, mercy, and love. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end.
Amen.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
The psalm for this evening is a portion of Psalm 85, found on page 439. Psalm 85, page 439. We shall say verses 8 through 13 together. I will hearken what the Lord God will say, for he shall speak peace unto his people, to his saints, and unto them that turn their heart to him. Surely his salvation is nigh them that fear him, that glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth are met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Truth springeth out of the earth, and righteousness hath looked down from heaven. Yea, the Lord shall give what is good, and our land shall yield her increase. Righteousness shall go before him, and shall direct his going in the way. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Our reading this evening comes from the first chapter of the Gospel of Luke, beginning at the 26th verse. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And yes, if you're keeping score, 5 months to Christmas. Our worship continues on page 723. Into thy hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into thy hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
For thou hast redeemed me, O Lord, thou God of truth.
I commend my spirit.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
Into thy hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
We say it together, the Tilicus Ante Terminum. Before the ending of the day, Creator of the world, we pray, that with thy wonted favor thou wouldst be our guard and keeper now. From all ill dreams defend our eyes, from nightly fears and fantasies. Tread underfoot our ghostly foe, that no pollution we may know. O Father, that we ask be done, through Jesus Christ, thine only Son, who with the Holy Ghost and thee doth live and reign eternally. Amen. Keep us as the apple of an eye.
Hide us under the shadow of thy wings.
Preserve us, O Lord, waking, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. We say together the Nunc Dimittis. Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Preserve us, O Lord, waking, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. We say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. In the language closest to your hearts, we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Blessed art thou, Lord God of our ancestors,
to be praised and glorified above all forever.
Let us bless the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Let us praise him and magnify him forever.
Blessed art thou, O Lord, in the firmament of heaven,
to be praised and glorified above all forever.
The Almighty and most merciful Lord guard us and give us his blessing.
Amen.
We say together the confession. We confess to God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed through our own grievous fault. Wherefore we pray God to have mercy upon us. Almighty God, have mercy upon us. Forgive us all our sins and deliver us from all evil. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness and bring us to life everlasting. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant unto you pardon and remission of all your sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Wilt thou not turn again and quicken us?
That thy people may rejoice in thee.
O Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
Vouchsafe, O Lord, to keep us this night without sin.
O Lord, have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us.
O Lord, hear our prayer.
And let our cry come unto thee.
The collect for this, the eve of the commemoration of Anne, the mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Lord God, the source and goal of all creation, we bless you for your servant Anne, whose daughter Mary was the mother of our Lord. Grant us grace in our succeeding generations to honor the gift of life, that young and old together may learn to love, whose fruit is life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Visit, we beseech you, Lord, this place, and drive from it all the snares of the enemy. Let thy holy angels dwell herein to preserve us in peace. May thy blessing be upon us evermore. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Be present, O merciful God, and protect us through the silent hours of this night, so that we who are wearied by the changes and chances of this fleeting world may repose upon thy eternal changelessness. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
I invite your prayers and petitions for the people and places that are upon your hearts this night, inviting you to name them out loud or share them in the comments box, where we may all enter into prayer along with you. We pray this night for all who are suffering from the coronavirus, for those who are in hospital, particularly in ICU beds, for the resurgence of the Delta and Lambda variants, and for those who are double vaccinated who are now struggling. We pray for those who are longing to be in medical care and cannot be, for all who are at home recovering, for all whose recovery is longer and complicated, for those who are awaiting test results, for all who are awaiting the vaccines. We pray God's healing hand be upon them and upon all who care for them. Praying this night for all who are suffering, for those who are struggling with mental health issues, particularly depression and anxiety, for all struggling with addictions, for those who are struggling with grief and the deep pain of the residential schools and the generational pain from that, for those who are struggling this night with from the forest fires, for those who've been traumatized, for those who are anxiously wondering about evacuations, for those who have been evacuated and don't know when they're returning home or what home they will return to, for all who are suffering and are waiting for doctor's appointments, diagnoses, surgeries, for all recovering from surgeries, for those undergoing treatments, therapies, and procedures, that God's healing hand will be upon them all and upon and will guide and direct those who have care for them. We pray for those who lead in the communities, as summer programming is underway, and for communities that are struggling with evacuations and communities trying to find ways to support others, that the leadership will be creative, engaged, and compassionate. We pray for those who lead across the province in these very difficult days, praying for the members of the Legislative Assembly, for the Premier of the Cabinet, for Dr. Henry and the work of her office, for the firefighters, the first responders, and for those in the hospitality industry that are welcoming and caring for those who have evacuated, and for all the many volunteers involved with those efforts. We pray for those who lead across the country, for those in the territories and provinces, for those who lead us federally, for the members of Parliament and the House of Commons and the Senate, for the Prime Minister, for the Federal Cabinet, for our new Governor General, it's tomorrow, I believe, mm-hmm. And for the work of Dr. Tam and her office in the procurement an ongoing study of the vaccines and the coronavirus. We pray for all who lead internationally, for all the struggles in the world and joys at this time, praying for all those who are competing in the Olympics in Tokyo, for the concerns not only of the virus, but of the weather, and for all the complications that brings, and for good competition and safe competition as the world has gathered for the games. And we pray for those countries that are struggling with violence, thinking of Myanmar, Syria, the Holy Land, praying for countries that are struggling with natural disasters, praying for all the nations and their leaders in these difficult days. As it is Sunday, we pray for the church and for its mission and ministry around the world, praying for Justin Welby, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Linda Nichols, our primate, Mark MacDonald, the National Indigenous Anglican Archbishop, Lynn McNaughton, our Metropolitan, for all who led in-person worship today and for those who gathered online, for the clergy and laity in all the parishes that give of themselves so we may come together as the body of Christ to serve in the communities where we are. And we pray for the work in the church, especially in those difficult and hard-stricken places, and praying for those communities that are responding to evacuees in this province. We pray also on Sundays for teachers and students that they may be enjoying their rest, for those students that are rolling into a second summer course this week, giving thanks that my niece passed her religious studies course with a little help. We pray for those who are planning the fall, for those in this educational system that are updating policies, procedures, for the IT departments that are still at work, for all those that are busy building, tweaking, and modifying buildings so that they may be safe places of learning for the students this fall, as we prayerfully gather students in class for this fall, both at the elementary and secondary levels, but also in the post-secondary. And we pray for those who are planning, especially seminaries, and doing hybrid learning and finding ways to meet the needs of the students and keeping them safe in these days, and forming them for ministry. And for those who are applying for the Diocese of Caledonia Vancouver School of Theology Certificate in Theological Education. With all these prayers and with those you've named, we pray. Be mindful, Lord, of thy people gathered before thee. Care for the infants, guide the young, support the aged, encourage the faint-hearted, collect the scattered, and bring the wandering to thy fold. Travel with the voyagers, defend the widows, shield the orphans, deliver the captives, heal the sick. Succor all who are in tribulation, necessity, anxiety, or distress. Remember for good all those that love us, and those that hate us, and those that have desired us and worthy as we are to pray for them. And those whom we have forgotten, do thou, O Lord, remember. For thou art the helper of the helpless, the saviour of the lost, the refuge of the wanderer, the healer of the sick. Thou who knowest each one's deed and hast heard the prayers, grant unto each according to thy merciful loving kindness and thy eternal love, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite your thanksgivings for this day, for those grace moments where you've seen the hand of God at work in your life and the lives of those around you. I am thankful to be back after an incredible whirlwind tour of almost all of Alberta, it seemed. Chance to visit with family and friends, and to to just spend time with them and to and to get up close and personal and forget about COVID for a moment in some ways. And in other ways, not, as you mask and glove and slather up with hand sanitizer. But it was quite lovely to be out. And for Traveling Mercies, only saw one bear in between here and Edmonton, and it sort of just sort of sat and waited for me to pass by. For the chance to gather with people in Chetwynd, Fort St. John, Dawson, and then today in Vanderhoof, in all the travels, and to have a chance to worship with them. And thankful for the dean taking care of the services so I could take off. And so with your thanksgivings, we pray. O most merciful Father, we humbly thank thee for all thy gifts so freely bestowed upon us, for life and health and safety, for power to work and leisure to rest, for all that is beautiful in creation and in the lives of men, women, and children. We praise and magnify thy holy name. But above all, we thank thee for our spiritual mercies in Christ Jesus our Lord, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. Fill our hearts with all joy and peace in believing through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We continue on the bottom page, 727. We will lay us down in peace and take our rest.
For it is thou, Lord, only that makest us dwell in safety.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The almighty and merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, bless, keep, and preserve you this night, and indeed forevermore.
Amen.
Thank you for joining us for our holy hug on the way to bed. Pray that you have a most restful night. Tomorrow, the dean will be next door at the cathedral for midday prayers at 12:15. And God willing, I'll be there as well. And then tomorrow night, I'll be back at 9 o'clock for another service of Compline. And I do want to apologize. I have heard many compliments about the wonderful scenery the dean presented in the background of the harbor. But we're back in the study. So, you don't want to see what's out behind the window. Just a bridge that goes from the road to the cathedral. Sorry for the scenery, but maybe we'll get him back upstairs at some point. So until we see you tomorrow, nighty night.
Have a hoop, as me.